Hello dear children, today we are going to start the new chapter, that is lesson number 13, present perfect tense. Okay, past lesson number 12 we had studied about present continuous tense. Now we will study about present perfect tense. When we talk about present perfect tense, that means the present perfect tense refers to the action. It refers to the action which started in past. First point is that the action started in past at an indefinite time. Indefinite time means time is not fixed or time is not known when it started, in the past. And then it continues to the present. It continues to the present and finishes there. Okay. So this present perfect tense refers to the action which started in the past and started or starts, we can say, starts in the past and continues in present. Okay, continues in present, or in present it has finished. In present the action has finished. Okay, like if we say we have just reached. Okay, we have just reached. Okay, so this sentence, when you see here, just, this word refers to the action, that the action has just happened or finished just now. Okay. Then one more, the car has arrived. Okay, someone says the car has arrived. Okay, so when it is said the car has arrived, that means the car just came before few minutes or few seconds. Okay, it started in the past at some time and then finished in the present. Okay, the same way we have just reached, they had started in the past and now the just in the present they have reached and finished. So here present perfect tense means that the action started in the past and finished in the present. At the moment of speaking, Before that moment, few seconds before, it has finished or just finished, we can say. Okay. Then some uses are given here. First use is, we use the present perfect tense to talk about an action, state or situation that started in the past and continues in the present. The same thing I told you here. Then we use two words here. Those two words are for and since. For and since. Since, for. Since we use for fixed time. Fixed time. And for is used for duration of time. Duration of time. Okay. So, since is used for fixed time and for is used for duration of time. For example, it is given, I have known Pavitra since 2007. I have known Pavitra since 2007. So, 2007 is the fixed time, therefore since is used. ओके देन आई हैव नोन महिमा फॉर 10 ईयर्स. आई हैव नोन महिमा फॉर 10 ईयर्स. सो 10 ईयर्स इज द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम. सो रिमेंबर दिस वन. देन नाउ वी कम टू यस टू मोर फंक्शंस आर देयर. सेकेंड फंक्शन इज गिवन एज टू टॉक अबाउट एन एक्शन व्हेन टाइम इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. सो वी यूज दिस प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट टेंस फॉर सच एक्शंस वेयर टाइम इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. लाइक आई हैव बीन टू इंग्लैंड. आई हैव बीन टू इंग्लैंड मीन्स वॉट सम डे और सम टाइम समवन हैज गॉन टू इंग्लैंड. ओके देन शी हैज रेड ऑल द हैरी पॉटर नॉवेल्स. ओके सो हियर टाइम हैज नॉट बीन गिवन एनी काइंड ऑफ इंपॉर्टेंस. Then third is to talk about an incident or an action that was completed the recent past. Recent past means what? Recent past means the moment which has just passed right now. Okay. Then we use the words just or yet. Just we use in the affirmative sentence and yet we use in the negative sentence. Remember this. Okay, if the sentence is negative, we will use yet, and if the sentence is positive or affirmative, there we will use just to suggest that action is being discussed at the time of speaking. Okay, like the train from Surat has just arrived. So at the time of speaking, the train has arrived there. Then the meeting has not yet begun. Someone has asked, is the meeting beginning or not? Then the person said, the meeting has not yet begun. Okay. Now we come to the structure of this tense. How we form the tense? In roughly we can say, has or have, has, have plus third form of the verb. This one is used in this present perfect tense. Has for the singular subject, have we used for the plural subject. And this third form of verb we use, this is third form of verb we say as past participle. This I told you to learn from the basic verb forms. Past participle. Okay, now we will see the structure systematically. Now, first comes declarative sentence. You can note it down where you have noted the other structures for the past lessons I have told you. So, singular, then plural. For singular, we write as he, she, it plus has plus third form of the verb. Then plural, I, we, you, they plus have plus third form of the verb. This is for declarative sentence. Okay. He has completed the work. She has completed the work. Okay, like this. Then the second one is negative sentence. For negative, singular and plural. Singular, he, she, it plus has not plus third form of the verb. I, we, you, they plus have not plus third form of the verb. Okay, now the third comes interrogative. interrogative. So this is negative and declarative. Only one difference is that we have just added not with the helping verb has or have. Okay, nothing else is changed here. Only not you have to add to make it negative. Now the interrogative sentence, you know that for forming interrogative sentence, we shift this helping verb to the beginning of the sentence or before the subject. Okay, so interrogative, singular and then plural. For singular, has, he has plus he or she or it plus third form of the verb and question mark. For plural, have plus he, sorry, not he, I, you, we, they, plus third form of the verb and question mark. Okay, so this is for interrogative. Has he completed the work? Has she completed the work? Has it broken itself? Have I completed the work? Have you completed the work? This way we can form the interrogative sentence. Okay, then one more WH, that is information questions are given. For that we have to just add here the WH word and it will become information questions. Okay, so this was the information or the explanation about present perfect tense. Always remember, present perfect tense, it begins in the past and completes in the present. Okay, begins in the past and completes in the present, that is present perfect tense. Understood? Okay, so you can note down this structure in your copy. Okay, so here the video is completed for this explanation. Thank you.